Dateline, Monday.
February 6th.
That's cinco plus uno, because I don't know six in Spanish. I should, but I don't. Anyway, it's temperature. It's 4:15 in the afternoon, Central Time. Temperature 55.8. So, that means no bar mitts. I'm still wearing long pants, waterproof pants, because it's supposed to rain. Gloves. My cycling boots because of the rain, because they're waterproof. Let's hit the go button on this.
Go.
So my feet are going to be hot. Hot feet. Hot feet. But better hot than wet, I guess. Yesterday on the way home because I forgot to format the drive. This. What the heck, man? Well, because I was sleepy, I wasn't paying attention. It's my fault. My fault. Got sleep last night, yay. Went to bed about 8 o'clock. Missed the Super Bowl. No, I didn't, because I wasn't going to watch it anyway. Heard it was really good, though. Yep. But anyway, who cares? As far as work goes, now here comes the car. I'm gonna go right across the highway. I saw him coming. Yeah, I saw you. But every day is a day from hell at work. So it rained a little bit this afternoon. Which isn't real warm, but with the humidity, it's not bad. And I'm going to Edwardsville. Going on down to Edwardsville. Because my puppy treats are running low. Right back at you, buddy. Chose to accept it is to ride to Edwardsville, Pet Smart, Puppy Treats, Sacred Grounds, and then home before the rain comes. Thank you. rain gear with me. I got my waterproof jacket. My pants are waterproof. My shoes are waterproof. I got my waterproof bar mitts, but I don't have them on. Hopefully we can avoid the jerk factor today. Let's see who gets their feelings hurt because I don't stop. This is gonna be tight. I don't know if it's gonna wait till 7 o'clock. I feel rain in the air now. Thank you. bus I would be taking if I took the bus. Because it rained, it was going to be sloppy. And two, I gotta beat the rain home. Well, I don't gotta, but it's supposed to get cold again later this week. And, you know, you get your, out there in the rain, water gets in places, doesn't all get out, and it freezes. And I had that issue I had the other day with my ship. No good, no good. Take these pants off because I'm getting warm. They're okay if you ride moderately. I've worn them in the summer in the rain, but oh yeah, you sweat like mad, but they are somewhat breathable. Ride hard in temperatures like this. No time to stop, no time to stop. Oh, looky, looky, caught up with the bus. Thank you. I'm getting warm. Pants. Complain. Guy had a big old trash bag on his seat. Yeah, I think I'm gonna pull the pants off at the Y. Still be wearing these high top boots and high top socks. I look like a greaser, but it won't be all sweaty, I hope. Oh, there's a lot of cars. Let's get over. Give me the green, give me the green, give me the green. Nope. Nope, nope, nope. Feels good out here. My legs are hot. When you're hot, you're hot. Really, buddy? Couldn't wait? Really? Couldn't wait, huh? Had to go, didn't you? Yes, couldn't wait. I'm an important man. I'm in a hurry here. I'll leave them on. What the heck? I better take them off. I'm gonna pull back here though. I'm gonna get undressed. The people are watching, even though it's just my outer layer of clothing. It's not like I'm in my underwear or naked or anything, but I kid you not, I'm getting hot and hot. We'll go through the grass up into the pavilion. All right, let's make this, let's make short work of this pantalone issue. My phone will have to go into my backpacker, so I will not be taking any phone calls. Zip up, there we go. Okay, now I'm looking like a complete goofball once I get these pants off. Because I'm telling you, I'm wearing boots. Boots and socks. Well, you know what? No, wait a minute. I got a pair of socks too, short socks. Oh man, if it was good on my feet, I might just ride barefoot. I can do that. And I'm sorry, I'm not putting this on film, but I'm on a borderline violation of all accepted standards of decency and hygiene right now. And I don't need to give the cops anything else to put me in jail for. Did you see that guy's feet? Yeah, I saw his feet. Lock him up, Dano. All right. Woohoo! That feels good. Too bad they're all nasty walking on this concrete, whatever the heck is on here. Okay, so I'm wearing high top boots, low cut socks. At least I don't look like a Nazi. Oh crap, I gotta take the pants off too. That's why I stopped for this. Really, I swear I'm trying to be fast. I just didn't want to stop the camera and have multiple files to upload. Pantalones go in the bagaloni with the rice-a-roni and the ring bologna. I should leave my gloves off too, because now I'm getting hot. Okay. Boots. It's our little secret. Nobody has to know. Oh crap, I'm on YouTube. Never mind. I guess everybody has to know now. Let's get the heck out of here. mama, that's the stuff. My feet, they may be a little warm. Stopped and did the Diana's Bakery cam. If you listen in the background, there is musica coming from one of the other establishments down there on Cherokee Street. And since I was recording just the ambient environment there, there's a surreptitious bicycle camera. The music playing at an elevated volume, thereby escaping the confines of the municipality. Well, no, it was still in St. Louis, so yeah, I thought it might have been in half. Anyway, I didn't cross state lines or anything with it. You can hear the music. And I don't know how people find this out. It must be some sort of algorithm, you know, like Shazam, that scours all of the files or patterns. Anyway, they found two songs that were playing during the Diana's Bakery cam by, what's his name? Thelonious Monk? Yeah, sounds like Thelonious, like a felon. But it's Monk. Oh, they have vehicles on this trail. Oh man, I see sun coming through the clouds over there. That's not gonna rain. Anyway, they let me know that from this time stamp to this time stamp, this song by Thelonious Monk was playing. And there were two instances, or two songs, that had played during the duration of Diana's Bakery Camp.
violation of copyright. Because Thelonious Monk's music is protected under the intellectual property right laws of the United States government. Excelsior. So I could either choose to remove the offending clips, which I think what they would do then is just drop the audio track and insert silence so you would hear nothing. Or I could file a dispute and give a reason why I was not violating a copyright. Granted, this thing's only a few minutes long. It's not very entertaining. The music itself is barely discernible. I don't even know how they figured out what it was. There's other background noise drowning it out. But I was born to litigate, so I filed a dispute.